I'm Mick Garris, and this is Trailers from Hell. You know, there have been a lot of really good Stephen King movies and a lot of really bad Stephen King movies, and I'm not here to judge by any means. But we're going to talk about one of the best this time on Trailers from Hell, The Dead Zone. It was 1983, and there had been a quick string of successes with Carrie, Salem's Lot, The Shining, Creepshow, and Cujo. The Dead Zone would prove to be a bit of a turning point for many of those involved. Dead Zone is the story of Johnny Smith, a school teacher who's about to be married when his life changes forever when he's hit by a truck and thrown into a 5-year coma. He wakes with psychic abilities that are more curse than blessing. Christopher Walken gives a truly remarkable performance as Johnny here. For me, it's his most human, his most emotional, his most heartbreaking role ever. There are none of the mannerisms that comedians mock so much today. It's really raw, open wound kind of performance that really works beautifully. And the humanity at the center of this story is what I think makes Stephen King's work so successful. The lousy King movies are the ones that think it's all about the monster in the closet. To me, the good ones realize that it's about the people who live in the house that have to live with the monster in the closet. So King's appeal, like that of Charles Dickens in another era, is that he lives in the world of his audience, that he isn't telling a story but living it with you. His people have a rich emotional core. David Cronenberg, who directed the film, captures this beautifully. It has a wonderfully dark and moody look, shot by Mark Irwin, and a great score by Michael Kamen, the only time since The Brood that Howard Shore didn't compose the score on a Cronenberg movie. And the death scenes, particularly the gruesome, self-inflicted scissors impaling of Nicholas Campbell's character, really show the director's hand. King is the first one to say that books aren't movies, that they aren't the same thing at all. But so far, at least, the ones that hew closest to the books have worked the best.
Stephen King, The Dead Zone.